know, my sisters and my brothers and my loves, whoever you are, whether you're a vampire, witch, or mermaid, doesn't matter. I'm born a hybrid witch, mermaid, and vampire. My name is Serena, and I will be helping y'all today on how to become immune to the full moon. Now, this is something that takes months to years to master, so don't feel frustrated if you didn't get it on your first or second or even third try. It took me like, I think, 2 years to become immune to the full moon. I mean, you never become like fully immune to the moon, but at least your emotions and powers will be in control wherever there is a full moon, and when you look up at it, of course, or after you look up at it. So, let's get started. So on full moon nights, I need you to meditate and try to keep calm. The full moon amplifies your emotions and powers, especially when you look into the moon's eye, or after you look into the moon's eye, you know what I mean. You'll feel giddier and happier and giggly, and you'll just, I mean, everything, all your six senses will be heightened, basically. So yeah, we need you to meditate and try to keep calm on a full moon night. Okay, here we go. Second, I need you to embrace the full moon. So unfortunately, you're gonna get moonstruck because you need to look at the full moon to embrace the moon. The more you do so, the more resilient you'll become when there is a full moon. Alright. During moonstruck, try to contain your emotions. Embrace your emotions while keeping calm. Try to make it seem like a normal night. Slowly you'll improve and becoming used to the moon's energy. So prepare for you to feel entranced for a long while with each full moon until you are calm about it. This is so hard to explain, but you definitely need to be moonstruck to become immune to the moon's eye. Even with the full moon rising, you will have heightened emotions, like I said before, but not as bad as after looking at in the full moon's eye. Alright, here we go. During a full moon, try not to use your powers unless by accident. Like I said, you need to try to remain conscious when it comes to a full moon and fight the enchantment as much as possible. Because when you're moonstruck, you want to use your powers. Like, it's just so tempting. You can't help it. Soon you'll feel more confident and more normal on a full moon night, despite feeling the high emotions from what we mermaids feel from the full moon. And that's all I have for now. Now, I never trained anyone on how to become immune to the full moon. I simply taught myself how to be immune to the full moon. And it took me 2 years, but I got it down pat. It's so hard for me to explain this, so I try to explain this in the best way I possibly can from my own experience or experiences. Just remember, you don't have to be scared of the full moon. Don't ever be scared of the full moon. Maybe it'll take you longer, maybe it'll take you lesser to become immune to the full moon. I mean, every mermaid is different, so you never know. Give it a try, everybody, you know? But yeah, that's all I have for you guys today. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you so much for supporting me and my magical life. I post a lot about my magical life on Instagram, so please follow me at serenamoonprincess. The username is right there in the video. Thank you so much for watching, my loves. Bye.